Hey everyone, and welcome to a video that Simon Parsons and I are doing together. You want to say hi?
No, not really. Okay, oh, well. Hello. Hello everyone.
It's going to be on his channel and mine. We're going to be doing our individual perspectives, so you can see my video on here and Simon's video on his channel, so you should go check that out on either side, because you may be watching this on his channel. Wow, doing it awesome. But today we're going to be building out a park area for Spawn. Is that what the official name of this little town is?
This is Spawn Village. It still needs a name.
Yeah.
And eventually I'm going to ask people to pick a name. So perhaps people want to start thinking about that now. But we've had this area laid out for a long time now as being the home of... We're going to build a library, a map room, and an enchanting room. And the rest of the area, we want to be a park.
Yeah, it's going to be... Oh, I'm so unprofessional. I'm so sorry.
Well, it's quite all right. I mean, given the time of recording, I'm probably going to start talking slower.
It is so late, so please forgive if Simon sounds super tired.
Yeah, and an extreme case is he actually starts snoring. If there's a thump, the sound of my head hitting the keyboard, just leave me be. It'll be all right.
Yeah. Okay, so we've got like a rough plan, and FYI, I told Simon if he doesn't like what I'm doing, he can just tell me I suck and I'll stop.
Yeah, there's so much scope there, really, isn't there? You know, sort of following April around here. No. That block, I didn't like you moving that block. No, you put it in the wrong place now. Sorry, no.
That'll make amazing entertainment.
Oh, absolutely, yes. For at least the first 5 minutes, yeah. And while April's running around down there, I'm going to be up here. I'm going to carry on building the library section, perhaps put the walls in, do a little bit more. So far... haven't done that much. Just got an entranceway. Might pretty that out a little bit. And I think I'm probably going to replace that with green glass. And I'm willing to bet everyone can guess why.
Yeah.
The vague shape.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
So people are going to come in to the library here. And this flooring here will be glass. Mm. I'm still trying to decide what color would be best.
I really like that blue.
Yeah, this the darker one.
Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah, I'm torn between... Well, actually, I kind of like the green one.
The green is lovely,
but
too.
But the blue will work well, I think, and it'll go well with the drapes. It'll be all right.
It will. Yes. It's very soothing,
yeah.
Too.
So I might want to color that in. So, while April is down there and doing her landscaping, I'm going to be putting some walls up.
Yeah.
Here and started to think about what we can do with this place. And in the meantime, we're going to talk about the witches and the why, and hopefully it'll be entertaining. And if not, hopefully it won't annoy people too much and or offend them. Yes.
Yep. So every once in a while, I'll pop back up and see what Simon's up to. But for now, let's.
And every now and again, I'll pop down there and criticize. Sorry. Yeah. Offer constructive criticism. That's it.
Yeah, yes. that'll be awesome.
Well, that remains to be seen.
But, no,
Okay. A lot of this, and whoa, we talked through the day again.
Oh, did we? Oh, crap.
Yeah, so let's quickly go sleep, and we'll start again in the morning.
Hey, I trapped myself.
I think this is about the 15th time we've said this, really, isn't it? Okay, we'll get organized a little bit more.
So.
Oh, there's a place I wanted to show you. We need to sleep now. Oh, we'll talk about something. Oh, it's night. We need to sleep now. We'll record next day. Oh, yes, okay. While we're organizing, it's got tonight. And yeah. we're so professional.
Man. Most professional. That's that's what you get here with Simon and Symbiote. All the professionalism in the world.
Yeah. I think that's the reason why you and Axiom Sugar like me so much, is because I'm quite happy to gossip like an old lady. So
yeah, it's good stuff.
Yeah, absolutely.
Excellent stuff.
Okay, so those people that haven't given up in disgust and are watching me, what I'm going to do is I'm going to build this around, just build the walls up a little bit, and then I'll give people a quick guided tour and show them what I'm thinking of doing with each individual area. So let's do the exciting well, bounce wall laying bit.
Oops.
I need some wall laying montage music for this, which I might put in later on.
Montage. Yeah, I'll have to add some music too. I always actually kind of get this perverse thrill going through Jingle Punks and picking out music.
Absolutely. I do adore them. I think they're really good. But I'm actually thinking of Yakety Sax for this at the moment. So. Yep, that's the one.
I'm a little too young to know that, but whatevs. So I'll talk about what I'm doing.
Okay.
What we figured is that the sort of water feature is going to travel underneath the library. Hi, don't suck, April. Underneath the library. Ultimately with the goal of having sort of a cascading effect. But what I want to do is something slightly asymmetrical, just to give it a more organic feel. And then I'll probably, if it's okay with you, Simon, I'll probably head underneath the library to work on that. I just really want to see what I get going on this outside.
That's good. Just don't knock down anything load-bearing, all right?
Yep, I'm gonna take out the library so hard.
I think that's my job.
Yeah, no, it's going to be beautiful. yeah. Wow. Hotness. Okay. Let's see. I've seen some things that people have built, and like they have rounded edges and things like that. Is that, how do you do that?
Okay. There's no such thing as a rounded edge in Minecraft. But stair blocks are quite popular.
Okay.
But anything that's actually rounded, in all honesty with you, anything that's actually rounded is done via mods. I mean, there's plenty of them out there.
Okay.
I just happen to consider them blasphemous, to be honest with you. But no, not really.
Well, I wouldn't do that to you.
Yeah. My personal game, which is a mod called Life in the Woods, is all pretty texture packs and nice shaders and things like that, and plenty of mods. It's basically about how to survive in the world as let's get two of those. It's basically vegetarian living and living in harmony with nature and things like that. So perhaps a touch less macho than me, a proper full red-blooded man, should be doing, but I quite enjoy it, to be honest with you.
You know, no, don't even worry about it. How much does that whole macho-ness thing really matter at the end of the day?
Well, answers in the comments, please.
As long as you are having fun. Yeah, I know most of your audience is actually male, and most of my audience is female.
Well, I've got to be honest with you, most of my audience is your audience these days, but no problems with that.
That's because you are amazing, and I'm glad that my viewers have realized that and come over to watch you.
I think they're all lovely, and thank you for coming along, and I love the comments. I really do enjoy answering the comments from people. Having conversations about Beth's cat, or is it me, or talking about what she had for dinner. I think it's just absolutely marvelous, and please, 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 please just keep it up.
Yeah, I totally understand. The comments are just great. I know we sound like we're bantering newscasters right now. it's so funny.
Well, in other news, yeah.
Yes. Well, you've got the voice for it, so take that as you will. Okay, I'm trying not to make this too asymmetrical.
Yeah.
But I can't help myself. I can fill in. I can fill in if I need to. I'm kind of like, what do you think about having, like, I mean, I'm kind of putting like a little island here. I can move it later. I don't know.
Yeah, why not? Why not?
I'm kind of modeling this
here,
on a...
Yeah,
I think it'll look good. I'm modeling it on a swimming hole that I used to go to when I was little.
Well, that's nice.
Yep, used to go. We call them in upstate New York, we call them cricks.
Now, okay, personally, I'm thinking these walls are turning out to be a bit boring, but I'm going to do a few bits and pieces of them. I want to put some windows in. And I'm also going to go and see if I can get silk touch on a pair of shears and get some vines. And I think some vines growing down this, and plants growing around it, and a few other bits and pieces of decoration. It's just going to perk up, but at the moment it's a bit cold grey walls,
yeah,
which is not the nicest thing in the world, but not the end of the world. But I think what we're going to do is I'm going to go and make some blue glass.
Okay.
And we'll put that in and we'll see what that looks like. If we put some plants, if we don't like it, then I just smash it all in a fit of pique and make some more.
Actually,
you had some glass somewhere.
I had to punch out some glass in my house and I almost cried. I was like, no. No, I made this glass and now I'm punching it in the face and that makes me so sad.
Yeah, I was utter shock the first time I was playing this game when I broke a glass block and I didn't get the glass block back. I'm like, what? No.
It's like, what kind of garbage is that? What sadist came up with this shenanigan?
Absolutely. Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow. This is bringing back memories. I used to love going swimming in like little watering holes, and
yeah,
I'm sure you had them in England.
I did. There was one area where there was a house right by the side of the river. It was a really deep river, and the house had a flat roof. So during the summer, we'd all climb up onto the roof of the house and dive into the river. The people who owned the house when I was a kid were obviously very tolerant people, because they put up with us loud mouthy shouty teenagers climbing up the side of their house all the way through the summer, and it was really nice of them.
Aww.
It's worth pointing out that the house has a sloped roof now, so somebody's obviously bought that house and decided they didn't like it quite as much.
Aww. Yeah, I don't, my grandmother had a friend who liked to, what stone is it? Sorry, I got distracted. she had a friend who had this really amazing swimming pool, and I used to go swimming there. It was so great. I loved it. Loved it. It was like 9 feet deep, and I was a competition diver when I was in high school, and I'd go and just dive and be a jerk and have fun.
And why not?
Yeah. I don't know. It's so weird to my friends that I was an athlete, because I don't have any athletic friends.
Well, anyone who knows me now would probably be absolutely amazed to know that I was a cross-country runner at school.
Wow. That's cool.
Anyone who knows my sense of direction is probably even more amazed.
Oh yeah, earlier we were trying to find the flower forest, and Sam was like, "Well, we're lost."
Yeah, I was talking to the Hell Kitty about that earlier on, and I didn't quite make enough blue glass, but that's going to make a little more. And we found one on the map, and we noted down the locations. And of course, I didn't keep the noting down, did I? So.
You know.
I went ploughed off merrily, thinking I knew roughly where it was, and I think we passed it, to be honest with you.
Yeah, I mean, it's a thing where I think as I explore more, I'll be able to help out in that capacity, because for those of you who've played Dark Souls, you know that you have to completely internalize the environments. Otherwise, otherwise it sucks.
I want you, ladies and gentlemen, to make a note of this, because it's rare to the point of never that Sims 3 Symbiote mentions Dark Souls.
Never.
Okay, it's never happens. Never at all.
I never mentioned my all-time favorite game.
Yeah, never at all. No.
I take it that you're implying something, Simon.
Nothing whatsoever. Nothing at all. Wouldn't dream of doing it.
Oh, okay. You're such a peach. Fair of skin, stone inside.
Yeah, that's about right. Right, okay, what I want to do, okay, is I'm going to build the walls up here, and the back here is going to be quite high, and I'm going to come over to a dome roof above this, I think, okay, and that's going to go up to a point. The reason being is fairly soon we're going to go and want to kill the Wither and get a beacon, and the beacon I think would look really nice there with its light coming out of the ceiling.
Nice.
And it is right in the center of spawn, so everybody will be able to get the effects of the beacon.
Cool.
And actually, the blue glass there will probably give it an interesting color. That's probably worth
it. Yeah, I think it'll look good. I'm putting down some torches so that we can avoid any jerk faces coming in.
So that's not a bad idea. Let's stick a few up myself. And here is going to be the map of spawn. I've got the one of the first things I did when I created this world was go and create a 2 kilometer by 2 kilometer map of the local area, and that served us quite well. So that will go up on the wall here, and we will build the rest of the world around it, and perhaps have some smaller scale maps of say spawn and things like that. And this will be the place to come to get the maps and update the maps and things like that.
Great.
And, yeah, it should be.
Now, for American audiences, a kilometer is a measurement you're probably bad at converting. So.
Okay. 1.6 kilometers to the mile.
Oh, okay.
So cool. It's about one and a third mile by one and a third mile, but that, you know, doesn't trip off the tongue quite as easily.
No. Yeah. Got our weird imperial measurements here.
Which, ironically, we came up with and don't use anymore. But there you go. Yeah.
Way to duck out.
Absolutely. So I'm going to duplicate the enchanting area here. So that's there. And I'll probably build the books further up.
Okay.
But I'm thinking of doing something. And I will probably steal a little bit of the park underneath here for a bit of a mechanism.
Sure, whatever you want to do.
Okay. And
ooh, pretty.
What I want to do is put some pistons under here and some machinery so that if you want to do an enchantment, let me just show you quickly, those people who don't know, enchantments on the enchanting table use the books to give a buff to the enchantment. So with all the books around them, you can do up to level 13 enchantments.
Nice.
Okay, but there sometimes you don't want to do that. You want to get a lesser enchantment, or you want to save some stuff. So if you block off these bookshelves, you actually get a lesser enchantment. So now if I put that axe on there, okay, I get 1, 5, and 4. We actually turn the enchantment levels all the way down, because if you remember right, almost lost my axe there.
Oops.
Without the torches here, put too many torches up. Hey, put way too many torches up.
Oops.
Right, without the torches there, the enchantments actually went up to level 30.
Nice.
Okay, so, and I've just flung my axe across the room again. Yay.
What?
So what I want to do is I want to push these bookcases up so less of them are talking to the enchantment book, and put a lever or something here so that you can pull the lever and some of the bookshelves go up. You can try the lesser enchant rather than messing around with the torches all the time, which is a bit messy and inelegant.
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah. All right, so that moved along a little bit. Let's go and oh dear.
What'd you do?
There I was, digging this hole, a hole in the ground, so big and sort of round it was, and there I was, digging it deep, it was flat, and at the bottom and the sides were steep. Yay.
I always tell Simon to sing, and he's like, no.
I don't sing, ever.
Yeah, no, never.
That wasn't me. I hire someone to do that.
Well, they're very talented.
No, they are indeed. Thank
you're
you
welcome.
Very much.
I know, I'm one to talk. I sing consistently in my videos.
Yes, don't say it too loudly, I have to pay them more. Okay, I think. Right, let's get some green glass.
Okay.
And replace the glass on this waterfall. That'll probably end up with me washing most of spawn away while I'm doing it.
No,
but
you
know. Yeah.
Such is life.
Mm.
Just try not to fill this in too much, because otherwise it'll look crappy while I try to do it.
New room underneath my house. I'll show the insides of that to people on my next episode, most likely.
Oh, yeah. I was going down the ladder, and I was like, wait, this is really long.
Okay, green dye. I only have the one. Probably only need the one, actually, so that'll be all right. And Let's just stick some of this around. There we go. 8 of those should do the trick. So
I wish I could get like an aerial shot. Hang on, I'm going to go up to the library and take a look down.
You can stand on the roof of Spawn Towers as well if you like.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no. Can I get up there?
Couple of little bits and pieces in Spawn's Tower that I still really, really want to finish, and that's one of them. But it's just, I'm like a fox in a hen house. There's so many things I want to do, and I'm starting things and not quite finishing them.
You've been absurdly ambitious when it comes to all of this.
Yeah, getting told off for not finishing them, and yeah, that's all fun though.
No, it's okay.
I'll get it done. Okay. I'll get it done, and then we'll reset the world, and we can start again.
It'll all look amazing. Oh, yeah, I think that's going to look really good.
Good.
I'm excited. So excited.
Right, let's get this. This is probably going to start a waterfall of epic proportions.
Nice.
Yeah, hopefully. And let's put some green here. Do it like this. And then we can do either side.
Oh, yeah, there's the water. Oops, hi. Close the doors, April.
And I'm going to have to...
Oh, I locked myself in. Wow. I am so good at things.
All right, let's do that. Let's give the water a chance to die down a little bit.
You sure you don't want to just flood us and completely inundate the town? I'm having a stroke.
Well, it's one way to start a game, really, isn't it?
Either that or cleansing fire.
So we'll take that out. We'll take that out now. Yeah. Water gets a little bit excited when you do things like this, but you just need to put some blocks in the right place to get it to calm down again.
Wow, I've got so much dirt. I'm going to have to go drop some off soon. For those of you who watch my videos, I've been doing a little more work on my house. I should show it off.
You should. It's looking good.
I don't know why I decided to go with some sort of like New Mexican thing, but whatever.
Oh, it works.
Yeah, it's fun. Yeah. Building in this has been way more fun than building in The Sims. I know I'm not supposed to say that. I made in one of my videos last night, I was making a basement for my vampires, and it's like a square. It's it's so lazy. It's got like beds and gym equipment, and that's pretty much it.
Right, let's get this water under control. Right, we want that. We don't want this. So if I just put some earth there, that'll encourage it not to flow down.
Okay.
All right, that calms that down a bit. And then once I've got it organized, all I want to do is come round again and take the earth out.
Okay.
Oh, where's that string coming
from? I should come up and see what you got going on. Let me see. Nice.
Let's make it a little bit less of a mess first, but
ideally.
Come on.
You can do it. There we go. Wow, you're doing that like a boss. So if you have a torch underwater, does it put out the torch?
It washes away the torch.
Oh, interesting.
If you want torches or whatever underwater, you need, well, there's other light sources that you need to use, basically.
Okay.
Glowstone lamps.
I really
want
to get some glowstone for my house.
Oh, let's take a run into the nether later on.
I'll have to do that. Although you're probably going to go to bed soon after this.
I don't know about that, but I might actually fall asleep after this. But, or indeed during.
Yeah, no.
You might want to open a book
Ideally, no sleeping right yet. What do I do with this pumpkin? There's like a pumpkin here and I don't want to murder it.
Just pick it up.
Do I punch it?
They're surprisingly hard to murder pumpkins.
Oh, okay. There we go. Oh, wait.
Oh, that's that jack-o'-lantern I couldn't know what to do and just left it there for illumination.
Yep,
isn't
there
it?
You go.
Right.
Crud
there.
My...
Finally, I got that to die down. Hey. Right, let's get rid of some of this
bone meal. My inventory is so full. Hang on a second. I'm going to go put some roses somewhere. Just temporarily. Go put them over at my house. It's not like I don't have a million roses here. Okay, so while we're here, if you want to see, I've been working on doing the glass. in my house, and I finally, thanks to Simon and Hellcat, I was able to get enough clay to start putting, making it all uniform color on this end.
Yeah, actually, we'll pop over and take a look at that in a little bit as well, I think. It's, because, let's be honest here, for a first build, it's absolutely incredible. I think we actually have this a little bit organized now. In fact, so organized, we've actually blocked up one of the streams, but we'll sort that out in a minute.
If you want to, while I'm doing this, if you want to take a quick peek at the lake and see what you're thinking of the shape so far.
I will do that.
Go put these roses out back. Oops. Hi. There we go. Don't be bad at things, April. Just ideally, let's stop that.
Oh, don't be bad at things. That's my job.
You're not bad at anything.
Says the man who spent the last 10 minutes fighting the waterfall that he built. Yeah, this is looking good. This is looking great.
Hey.
Yeah, some plants, a little bit of pathage, some seats.
I think it's going to look good. And yeah. We have a lot of... we have a lot of libraries and stuff that look like that here. Although our library is really old. I'm sure, well, you're in England. Your stuff is all old.
Well, you got to bear in mind here that... okay, right. There's a couple of bits and pieces here. First of all, I grew up in a very rural environment. And my village library was actually a Nissan hut. Okay. And Nissan huts, for those of you that aren't British, were basically these prefabricated buildings that were made during World War II for organizations, for councils, town halls, in many cases actually actual housing.
Okay.
And after the war, they were just basically left there, so they were given to whatever council wanted them.
Nice.
And yeah, as a kid, you know, Nissan huts were, you know, sort of scout huts. And as a kid, I was in the Army Cadets. There was one of them. And so was our library.
Hmm.
And that library, my library growing up was absolutely fascinating. It wasn't so much a library. It was just a place where good books went to die. So you would find in the library, and I did on the one occasion and enjoyed both of them, a status quo biography on a shelf next to Mein Kampf, which, British rockers who knew three chords and Mein Kampf. Yeah, I can see the similarities there. Yeah, that was just wonderful. That was, and I spent many a happy hour there. Is that too tall? Yeah, that's too tall. Let's make that a bit shorter, and hopefully without flooding the whole of spawn at the same time. Alright, so,
don't.
Yeah. Well, again, and again, the word is again. Okay. I think we might want to stick a light behind that if I can, but that's not too bad. It's not too bad. And I've totally forgotten the second point, but it'll come back to me. Oh yes, that was it. When I was a teenager, just after I left school, I worked for a little while as a tour guide in Southampton, which is a city nearby where I lived. I'm sorry, this is going to be very uncomplimentary to Americans, and I do apologize for that. And I'm going to stand outside of April's house first and just let you guys have a look at it while I'm talking. I did a tour guide, and we'd be showing people around the city. It's a very, very old city. It's got the world's oldest bowling green, for example, which was made in the 1300s. The walls were made over a 700-800 year period. It's got a hell of a lot of history. It was almost bombed out of existence during the Second World War. Well, that's a nice angle. Because it was the place where the Spitfire was made. The Spitfire, if you don't know, was the premier British fighter. It pretty much won the Battle of Britain for us, which basically stopped the Germans from advancing. And it's a very, very important part of British history, European history in general. So, yeah, there's a lot of history there. And but because it was bombed so heavily, most of it was rebuilt after the war. So yeah, we'd be showing people around, and there'd be a sort of a Tudor manor house next to something made in the 1960s, and almost inevitably, tourists would point at the stuff that was made, you know, 40, 50 years ago, and gee, isn't that old? And then turn around to see me, just sort of gently headbutting the floor. It's, I'm sorry. It's one of those things. Growing up in a touristy area, you get a sort of genial, general contempt for tourists in general. And people ask me what I did in the bank holidays when I was a kid. You know, bank holidays are public holidays here in Britain. And the answer was hide, because everywhere I knew was going to be full of tourists. Yeah. So, but, you know, there was lots of entertainment, you know, sort of walking behind people saying, yeah, what's all this green stuff then? And, you know, just go up quietly behind them and say it's nuclear fallout.
You tricky guy.
Yeah. Yeah, I started off evil early, I'm afraid. What can I say? But, yeah, so, yeah, there's loads of old stuff, loads of new stuff. And, yeah, I mean, Britain is full of a lot of old stuff, but it's also stuff that's been rebuilt constantly over the years. So it's actually quite surprising. You will, in all honesty, find, you know, the street I live in, okay, has a load of 25-year-old houses with a 400-year oak tree in the middle of them. Yeah, that's the way it goes. So let's talk Minecraft for a second, shall we? Let's actually build something, because I've just been walking around in circles vainly trying to fight the water. Right, let's put these walls up a little bit further, and then we can start getting a bit decorative.
Sounds good. Actually, I mean, not to change the subject back, but on that note, our house is actually 180 years old. And, yeah, this is one of the oldest areas in New York, so I understand. And we're a college town. It sucks.
No sarcasm intended. That's a... It's interesting to say you live in a house almost as old as your country.
Yep. It's pretty cool.
I mean, if I was to try doing that, it would have to be made out of wattle and daub, or, you know, sort of a mud hut somewhere.
Oh, wait, crap. Fraps is crashing. Oh, I think my game is crashing. All right.
See you in a minute.